this special edition of the Jim Baker Show. Coming to you from the village of Morningside, snuggled in the beautiful Ozark Mountains. Today, it's a Baker family reunion with Jim's daughter, Tammy Sue Baker. And now, coming to you from Gray Street and Morningside, here are your hosts, Jim and Lori Baker.
Welcome to Gray Street. Wow, what a very special day. Tammy Sue is back. And here at Morningside, don't miss a minute of this show. Call a friend. This is the greatest moment of my life.
I just want to look at you.
And look at that long, beautiful hair she still has, everybody. You know, look at that.
You know what? There's a. I want you to look at something. Sweetheart.
Yes, I see.
There's a condo. See the blue condo?
Oh, that condo. See the condo.
The people that own it are, they have to cut back because they've gotten, well, they can't travel all the time. Mm-hmm. They're the most wonderful people in the world. I want to buy that condo for you.
Yes.
Yes. So anytime you come.
Sam.
No, I'll tell you something. When she was 16, she recorded a fabulous 33 and a third. What do you call those things? LP.
An album. An actual album.
16 years old. Do you remember how much
crazy
that record made?
It's too much.
For the ministry?
I think it was $1.6 million.
It did.
$1.6 million.
Yeah. Back then.
Yeah, 16. So it was $1.6 million.
Can you imagine?
For the ministry.
That would be worth now.
And I promised her at Heritage USA that she would have.
This
come on back.
Our,
come on back.
This is in our hallway every single day we pass by you, and we pay homage to you.
There, oh, she gorgeous thing.
That's
look
a
at
long
it. She
time
that
ago.
She was. I
the old gray we, mare ain't what she used to
I don't
be.
Know if you were.
Better. Think, she's
you
better.
Were. Weren't you 15 when you
15,
started it? She was 15 years old when she started produce. When she produced actually, and it was 16 years old, and we were building Mulberry Village high-rise towers, at that time. We were geared to build one a month. That's how fast Morningside was growing when people decided they wanted me to come down and used my sin to do it. And the top floor had this big attic part that they weren't going to use, and I figured out I want to use that empty space, and that's going to be Tammy Sue's condo.
Yeah.
And she was... We never got royalties. None of nobody, Tammy Faye, Jim Baker, we never got royalties. People, most preachers make their money from their books and their records. I gave away millions and millions and millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of dollars of royalties. I'm not bragging. But I decided that Sue, since she didn't get paid, should have a small royalty off her record back then. And I promised it to her, and we were in the process of doing it. And I put her royalty money in the bank, and nobody knows this. I'm gonna confess right in front of you. When the world fell apart, we had to live off her royalty money. And I never fulfilled the promise that she would have a place. She does not own a home. She's never owned a home. I just think, Sue, I don't know how I'm going to do it. But, and I know you don't want it. You've never asked me for anything. And you kept my ministry alive when I was in prison. She ran it. When everybody walked away, she ran the ministry while I was in prison. And she came to that prison to see me whenever she could. And she brought baby James. Go get the drawing off the wall, somebody.
In his office.
Baby James, the night before I went to prison, we stayed in a hotel room together. And James... was
actually,
this big. How old was James? Do you?
I think he was 9 months old, and you stayed
do you
up.
You remember
and
James?
He He stayed up all, I have to say, you stayed up all night with him, you told me, which was great. He said,
you were tired.
He said, you sleep, and when the baby gets up for anything, I'm going to take care of the baby. And he took care of the baby all night long the night before he went to prison.
That was the last thing I did. And then I had one picture with you and baby Jane, and I took that picture to all the prisons with me. And James kept me alive. I'm so emotional about this kid, and he's still keeping me alive, that when he walked off the plane when he got here,
it was kind of egotistical,
but it looked like I was walking off the plane when I was 16. I mean, that's how I felt.
True.
But I'd hold that picture of you and James, and I'd hold it up when I was in the insane asylum prison they threw me in.
I remember.
And I'd hold that and not so I couldn't see anything else. And so then when I went to prison, one of the inmates with pencil drew this moment when she brought James to see me. That's from a pencil drawing. I looked a lot younger and I had hair back there. Still, I had hair when I went to prison. During one time when they put me in diesel therapy, which only prisoners know what that is. They chained me and moved me for... I went to the worst prison in America, the hell prison. I almost died in the prison because I didn't eat, because they told me the dining rooms were the most dangerous place, dining room. That's funny. I didn't know. I just didn't go. And I was dehydrated and didn't know it. And a lawyer that loved me called the prison. And they sent the guards there and they took me to the doctor and found out that I would have died shortly. I have not told the story much. Baby James was with me in that prison. He was with me in all seven prisons I was in. And now baby James, sweet baby James, you know the song.
We love that song.
That's why I call him baby James. It's good to have hope. But at times, all the hope I had was James, Sue. And then he came to prison. And I don't know, was this visit? I don't know how old he is in this picture. James, how old do you think you are?
One, two.
When he was beginning to talk, Sue always kept my picture on the refrigerator. So they knew me. My grandbabies knew me. Do you remember he walked up to the big prison and he said, do you remember what he said? Yep.
He said, Papa.
Yeah. He said,
I said, Papa, you have a really big house.
She didn't tell him I was in prison. She just said, and so he goes up, he says, Papa has a big house. Yeah, Papa was in the big house.
A lot of guests there, too.
Yeah. And so one of the inmates made this drawing. And one day I remember I was really in bad shape, and you bring baby Jonathan.
Yep.
And I didn't know you were coming then either. Oh, Nana, I don't know what to do. Help me, baby. My daughter's, Nana's the producer. Kevin, would you sing with her?
We could do that, yeah.
The blood. Could you want to do the blood? And
I love Tammy Sue, but you know, I love it because when I touch her, I feel Jim. It's the weirdest thing. Every time I've always said that.
Ever since you guys were first together,
she'd come up and she'll just rub me and touch me like that. And it's his touch. It's the most. It's the craziest thing. And I just couldn't wait to feel your touch again. I love you so much. So amazing that you would do this for your dad.
Oh.
Can you imagine? There's your baby.
That's a miracle.
This child right here grew up on Christian television. She grew up. All those little pictures, right, Mondo, that we've seen so many. Little Tammy Sue running around the set.
Tammy Sue was literally in the studio the first days of her life. She grew up. The baby stages in a bassinet. Donna was there. Donna knows. And then her friends were all the directors and all.
They have stories.
I got a lot of new friends introduced her to. And then when she got about this high, she would do the kids show. Did the kids show 8 years.
That was the puppet show that you guys
had. And it was an amazing show. I mean, what it did. It built Christian television, whether anybody wants to admit it or not. The kids tuned them in on that. You had to have a separate tuner on VHF, and that was in that day. And every once in a while, you would see this puff of something go by the bottom of the screen. So right on your bottom of your screen, you'd see this little bunch of black hair going by. You didn't know, nobody knew what it was. It was Tammy Sue. That was her house.
The cameraman said when I was this little, I used to duck under the camera.
Oh.
You know, I could walk under it.
She could walk under when she was really tiny.
That is so cute.
And she'd go sit in the control rooms and she'd. But let's try. I know it's difficult, honey.
She's a pro. You know what the thing about her? Just let her do her thing because she's got it in her. You have it in you. The anointing is so strong on you and it's such a blessing. You are seeing restoration. You know what you're giving? You're giving people hope. You got it, okay? You're giving people hope. Because so many people's children are out there, and they want them to come back.
Can I just say...
Just preach, girl.
Preach. If you have kids that don't agree with you, just agree to disagree. You know, because there's a lot of stuff that Dad and I don't see eye to eye on, but it doesn't mean that you don't love them. You know, just agree to disagree, because life is so short. It's not worth holding grudges. Not that I held a grudge, so don't read into that, but... It's not worth it. And if you're here today and you have any issues with your son or with your daughter, with your mother, with your father, I just encourage you today to just let it go. It's not worth it. It's not worth holding on to. Go to that person. Go to your mom. Go to your dad, your son, your daughter, your family member, and just say, you know what? It's done. I love you. Because it's just so important to do it while they're alive. You know, I can't stress that enough. I just can't.